Today was the graduation concert of an idol that I followed back in the day, Kanatomo, from an idol group called Juice. She was the leader and she's been doing it for how many years, I wonder? 7, 8, 9? But when you do this for such a long time in your life, I totally understand that at some point it's just time to move on, do something else, because a job like that really limits you. They can't like have like also like proper relationship. They can't just get married and stuff. And also school is tough. And also they can't just go hang out and it's not so easy to hang out and do stuff in public as an idol. Always gotta be careful with who they're seen with and how they're seen, and or not be seen at all, to not get stalkers. Oh my god, especially if you're that popular, when people follow you home, then oh my god. So it's tough, I understand, definitely. Even when it's sad seeing my favorite idols leave, it's understandable. My favorite idol from back in the day has 2 children now and is married. Sad to see them go completely, because you'll wonder like, oh, I wonder what that girl that I was supporting, my Oshi, I wonder what she's doing now. And you can't check up on them anymore. Until now, for most of them, I was able to check up. Fans have to accept that, though. I'm sure that the idols, I'm sure that they also have a hard time dealing with it, because if you're in that spotlight, in that entertainment world for like so many years, then you get used to having constant attention. You get used to always having someone to listen to you, to your stupid first world problems and all that kind of stuff, and your stupid small talks that no one would care about if you lived a normal life and were in a normal workplace. And probably most people wouldn't care about all these things that people care so much about when it comes to idols. And now after, let's say, 10 years of these activities, you say, okay, I'm leaving this world, which is totally understandable, because you gotta go back to becoming a normal human. You might not even know how to lead a normal fucking life. I was thinking about that too, how I would feel. Before whole life, I was thinking about it, how I would feel if I would, you know. But it didn't end there. Then I joined Whole Life, and now I have so many more people paying attention to me and my stupid tangents that normally no one would give a shit about. But you care about it. You care about these things that you don't even know what I'm talking about. You listen to me, and you worry about me, even about the tiniest things. When I say, oh, I didn't like this food that I ate, then you're gonna be like, oh, I'm so sorry. Here, you should eat this, you should try that. Oh, why didn't you like it? It's normally, people would be like, whatever, what do I care? Shut up. But when I take my stupid pictures of my food, then also you're so interested. Even though it doesn't even look special. Or when I talk about, you know, the shows I watch on Netflix. Although I do feel like many of you guys don't like the shows that I watch. I do feel like when it comes to that, you guys don't really listen. You shut off your brain. The moment I start talking about Desperate Housewives, you're like, oh, here she goes again. When it comes to that, that's when I lose you guys. Oh man, I thought you guys join me and follow me wherever I go and listen to me whatever I say. But when it comes to Desperate Housewives, it's a good show!